There's an idea in photography that cameras with different size sensors have what we call crop factors. A large format Alexa 65 has a crop factor of 0.56 times compared to a Super 35 camera. A 90mm lens multiplied by 0.56 is 50mm. Therefore, many people say that using a 50mm lens on this camera is going to look exactly the same as using a 90mm lens on this camera. The truth is that this isn't exactly 100% correct, for quite an important reason. So let's go over a more detailed explanation on what crop factor is, how it works, and the big misconception about it. This video is brought to you by MUBI, a streaming service that screens beautiful cinema from all around the world. Get a free month at mubi.com/indepthcine. As photochemical film photography emerged and cinema cameras were created, there was a push to create film with a standardized size that could be used across different cameras from different manufacturers and be developed by different laboratories around the world. That film had a total width of approximately 35mm and therefore was called 35mm. When digital cinema cameras started getting manufactured, they replaced film with photosensitive sensors that stuck to the approximate size of film's 35mm 4-perf capture area. However, along the way, some more niche formats emerged, from smaller 16mm film that was a cheaper alternative, to large format 65mm which maximized the resolution and quality of movies at a higher cost, to tiny 2/3-inch video chips from early camcorders, to smaller micro 4/3 photography sensors. The issue is that when you put the same lens on two cameras with different sensor sizes, they will have a field of view that is different, where one image looks wider and one looks tighter. So for prospective camera buyers or renters to get a sense of the field of view each camera would have, many manufacturers started to publish what they called a crop factor to determine this. This means you take your lens's focal length, for example a 35mm lens, and multiply it by the crop factor of the camera, such as 2 times, to arrive at a new focal length number, 70mm. This means that on the smaller sensor, your 35mm lens will have approximately the same field of view or magnification as a 70mm lens on a Super 35 sensor. Since Super 35 sensors are considered the standard size, this has a crop factor of 1 times. Camera sensors larger than 35mm would have a crop factor of less than 1 times, and sensors that are smaller than 35mm would have a crop factor of more than 1 times. So where does the myth part come in? Well, the issue is that many people interpret crop factors as saying that shooting with a 70mm lens on a Super 35 sensor is exactly the same as shooting with a 35mm lens on a smaller sensor with a 2x crop. What's important to note is that while the level of magnification of the image may be the same, there are still a bunch of other characteristics that lenses have that will make images different depending on what focal length is chosen. So what we should say is that a 70mm lens on a Super 35 sensor has approximately the same field of view of a 35mm lens on a smaller sensor. We shouldn't say that a 70mm lens on this camera is exactly the same as a 35mm lens on this camera in every way, as different focal lengths come with other secondary characteristics beyond just their field of view. Rather than different sensors magnifying or zooming out on the width of what we see, it's better to think about it in different terms. If you put the same lens on two different cameras with a larger sensor and a smaller sensor, the way that the light enters the lens and creates an image will be the same. The only difference is that the camera with a smaller sensor has less surface area to capture the image with. This makes it feel like the image is cropped in comparison to the larger sensor, which can capture more of the surface area and therefore produce an image which feels wider. Calculating crop factor and then changing the lens on the camera to a more telephoto lens may make the width of the images match, but will also change the very nature of the image by altering the depth of field, the compression, and the distortion in the image. The smaller the sensor is, the more cropped in the image will be, and therefore the wider focal lengths you will need to use. Whereas the larger the sensor is, the wider the shot will appear, which means cinematographers will often choose longer, more telephoto lenses. One of the secondary effects from using longer focal lengths is that it will create a shallower depth of field. This means that the area that's in focus will be much narrower on a telephoto lens, which means the background will be softer with more bokeh. Which is why movie shot on cameras with large format sensors bigger than Super 35 like the Alexa 65, which cinematographers pair with longer focal length lenses, will have a much shallower depth of field with soft out-of-focus backgrounds. It's a misconception that larger sensors create this effect. In fact, it's the longer focal length lenses that do this. Another effect that focal lengths have is on how compressed the image is. Wider focal lengths expand the background and make objects behind characters appear further away. Telephoto lenses compress the background and have the effect of bringing different planes closer to the character. For this reason, cameras with smaller sensors that need to use wide lenses may produce images that appear a bit flatter without much depth, especially in wide shots. While large format cameras with their longer lenses compress the background to create a bit more of a layered perception of dimensionality. Wider lenses also have a tendency to distort the image more, so shooting a close-up of an actor on a Super 35 camera with a wider focal length will expand their face and make their features unnaturally larger, while using a longer focal length on a large format camera with the same equivalent field of view will compress the faces of actors a bit more, which many say is a bit more flattering. Although modern digital cinema camera sensors come in many shapes and sizes, in general they conform to a few approximate dimensions. Some cameras come with the option to shoot a very small section of the sensor that is equivalent to 16mm film. This has an approximate crop factor of 2 times compared to Super 35. This little format will usually be paired with wider lenses designed for 16mm, such as the Ultra 16 Primes, which range from 6mm up to 50mm focal lengths, which with a crop factor applied, produces a field of view of around 12 to 100mm when adjusted for Super 35. As we discussed, this 6mm will produce an image with extremely limited bokeh and a deep depth of field that feels quite dimensionally flat. Next, we have Super 35 sensors, which are usually considered standard, such as we find on an Alexa 35 or Red Helium. Each manufacturer produces sensors with subtly different dimensions, but most will be the approximate size of 4 per 35mm film and produce the standardized field of view where a 18 to 24mm focal length feels wide, a 35 to 50mm lens is about a medium, and anything longer at around 85mm starts to have a compressed telephoto feel. Anything bigger than Super 35 size is usually considered to be large format. This includes full frame sensors modeled on still cameras that are approximately 36 by 24mm. Some examples are the Arri Alexa Mini LF, the Sony Venice 6K, or the Sony FX9. These cameras will have a crop factor of somewhere around 0.67 times, which bumps a wider perspective up to around 32mm, a medium field to around 65mm, and a telephoto lens to about 110mm. 65 cameras like the Alexa 65 push this even more, with their approximate 0.56 times crop factor, which makes a 45mm lens a wide, a 90mm lens a medium, and a 150mm a telephoto. As we discussed, shooting a wide field of view with a 45mm will produce much more compression, bokeh, and dimensionality than using a 12mm lens on a 16mm camera, even though they'll produce a similar field of view. It's important to note that these crop factor numbers are all relative to what sensor size is considered the standard. For example, in still photography, a full frame sensor is usually considered normal with a 1x crop factor, which means smaller APS-C sensors, which are roughly close to Super 35, will have around a 1.5x or 1.6x crop factor. What is much more important than getting super technical about these crop factor numbers is understanding how larger or smaller sensor sizes affect the field of view, and understanding all the secondary effects that using different focal lengths will have on the image. The trick with cinematography is taking all this technical camera geekery and actually applying it to making movies. One of my favorite streaming services to watch films on is MUBI, the sponsor of this video. Since we're talking about crop factor, let's look at two different films streaming on MUBI shot in two different formats. First, we have Christopher Nolan's extremely low budget first film Following, which he shot himself on the smaller gauge 16mm. Watching this is a great insight and introduction to a director with a clear vision and voice, whose stylistic trademarks from this film would continue to build into some of his later monster blockbusters. On the other end of the crop factor spectrum, we have This Much I Know To Be True, a musical performance documentary shot by DP Robbie Ryan on a large format camera that enhances its super wide field of view. To check out their full catalogue of films, you can try MUBI free for 30 days at mubi.com/indepthcine. That's mubi.com/indepthcine for a whole month of amazing cinema for free. Hope you enjoyed the video. As always, thanks to all of you for supporting the channel by watching, commenting, and especially to those that get the videos early on Patreon. Otherwise, until next time, thanks for watching and goodbye.